Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullin and this week I'm going to show you how you can do your daily planning and prioritization using Apple Reminders. Now, Reminders app is not the most heavily featured task manager out there, but it doesn't have to be. In fact, usually the best task managers or to-do lists are the ones with the least amount of features, because that means there's less to fiddle with, there's less to play around with, so you can actually spend more of your time focused on the work that matters. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Apple's productivity suite of apps, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account now, and I will show you how to do daily planning using your Reminders app. Okay, so here we are with Reminders open. And as you can see right here, Reminders is set up for the time sector system. Now, that's one of the beauties of Reminders is in its lack of features. More features means there's a lot more to play with and adjust and to fiddle with, and that just takes you away from what a task manager is meant to do, which is to show you what you have decided needs to be done today. So with that, you have in Reminders, we've got five, and I'll show you that in a moment. We've got four smart lists. That's today, which means anything that's actually dated for today. We've got scheduled, and that's anything that you've added a date to. So if you go in here, you've got all the tasks that I've got in this demo account that's got a date attached to it. All my tasks, that's everything, and it's all organized by project. So I use the time sector system, so this is all organized by project. And then we have flagged, which is anything that you have that is flagged. So that's the tool set that we have to play with. There's not a great deal more, but that is perfectly okay. So how do we use this for planning our days and planning our weeks? Well, let's go back to today. Let's imagine that this is a normal day. I've got seven tasks that I want to get done today. So what I'm going to do is, when I come to planning my day, I'm going to plan the day before. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to start right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to schedule these for tomorrow. Now, the problem here is that it's not so easy at the moment, but there is a quicker way to do this, but I want to show you this. So we can go into the information right here and click on that and just shift it to tomorrow like that. Hit return, and that's going to go in. And they're going to disappear. Or we can just go in here and we can change that to tomorrow by just tapping on the date like this, which actually I find this is the fastest, which, hang on a minute, we just tap on the actual task. It brings up today, tap that, move that to tomorrow, tap this, move that to tomorrow, and so on and so forth. So we can actually just move these, we can move these by tapping on that, click on the date right there, and tomorrow, and so on. So that's one way that we can do it. And I'm going to leave those in for today. So let's imagine that it's the end of the day. I've got these two tasks left, and I haven't managed to get them done, although Benji does need his medicine. So that's daily at 6 p.m. So I can just check that one off. That's going to come up for tomorrow. And that's done. Okay, and as you can see, it's disappeared. Right. So end of the day, there's only one task I haven't done. Let's go start doing the planning. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into scheduled right here, and that shows me all the tasks that I have scheduled. So I'm looking at tomorrow, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to count my tasks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've got 9, and this is actually going to be needing to be done tomorrow. Now, the thing is, what you would normally do, as you've just done there, is I would just tap on that, and then I would change that date. But when you're doing the planning, you act in the scheduled view, you actually have an additional tool that you can use. What you can do is you can just grab hold of that, and not like that. it's a bit of a delicate matter, but you can grab it like this and you can just drag it down into tomorrow. And there you go. I've added it in for tomorrow. And that is all done. So now I've got the 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 tasks for tomorrow. So I'm now ready to organize my 2+8 planning system. What is the 2+8 planning system, I hear you ask? Well, that is essentially a prioritization system where you select two tasks that are your must-do tasks for the day. Now, this could be anything. It could be work-related tasks, and well, tomorrow being Saturday, right now, tomorrow will be Saturday. So I'm thinking, okay, I'm not going to be working tomorrow, so I'm looking at my personal tasks. These are going to be my objectives for tomorrow. But it could be a work day, and I might decide, okay, my work things, like finish the paper on benefits of deep work, might actually be the priority for tomorrow. So what I want to be doing, though, is I want to be able to distinguish what my objectives are for tomorrow. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be looking down here, and I'm going to say, right, I do need to get the car serviced, and so that has to be done. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on the iClick button at the side there, and I'm just going to tap flag. I'm going to flag that one. That's what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. Now, remember, this is a daily planning session. This is something you want to be doing every single day. The other thing I want to be doing, I do want to write 500 words on my book. So that's it. I'm going to flag that one. And now I have my two objectives for tomorrow. Now, the thing is, when it comes to the start of day tomorrow, you start in this smart list right here called Flagged. So you go in there, and that is where I start my day. This is how I am going to do where I'm going to start my day. This is what I'm going to make sure gets done tomorrow. So arrange for Bentley to be serviced. That's great. I pick up the phone, I call the service center, and I get it booked in. Write 500 words of my book, then that's great. All I do is once I've called the garage to have the Bentley serviced, then I sit down and I write my 500 words of my book. Job done. That's great. Let's go back to the scheduled. Now, as I'm planning tomorrow, I'm thinking, you know what? I'm not going to be able to talk to Moneypenny tomorrow because she's away on holiday this week. So I'm going to need to speak to her on Monday. So I can grab that task and I can just drag it down to Monday. And this is where it's super, super fast to be able to organize and move your tasks around. I'm not going to be able to finish my deep... Brian, I'm going to have to speak on Tuesday. So let's just drag that down. I'm going to drop that one in on Tuesday, like that. Now, by the way, you can do this on your iOS device, or it's actually much easier on your iOS device, either iPad or phone, because you just click and drag down from the scheduled view. It's really quite easy. So as you're going through this, you think, right, that's my day. Now, as of right now, that's iOS 14 point, I guess it's 14.4 or whatever. We don't have the functionality yet to sort these tasks. Now, you can, if you go into your menu, you'll see view, sort by, and most of these are blanked out anyway. You can actually do it, but it's not very functional. I find it doesn't work very well. However, if you're when we move to 14.5, and I will do a video on this, we will get the ability to sort these much better, and I will show you a video, which is a great way of finishing off your planning. But right now, we don't have great functionality there, and even within this task, I can't move these tasks around. But that's okay, because what I've done is I've managed to sort out with my flag task there, right there. That's done. It's great. I'm ready to go for the week. And this is just a wonderful view to go through. So I can go through this as I'm doing a weekly planning session, and I can think, oh dear, Tuesday, I'm going to be away all day. So I'm not going to be able to call Brian on Tuesday. So I better make that Monday, and I'm not going to have time to do the presentation. So I'll do that on Wednesday. You know, you can just quickly shift things around like that. And that's using macOS Big Sur on the iPad and on the iPhone. It is just so much easier. So there you go. That's how I would do the planning sessions using reminders. You've got the drag and drop functionality on in the scheduled smart list. It's really, really easy to do. It's even easier to do on your phone and on your iPad. And you've got this view. You can just go, right, I'm ready to go. And again, when you go into today, you can go through your projects straightforward right here. You can go through your various projects and see, are these tasks still relevant? And one quick tip while you're still scheduled, what you'll notice is, as I'm doing my planning, what I can do is think, oh yeah, I need to do something. So I can click on there and go shopping, for example. And that is going to give me, if I just hit return, that is actually going to give me the task that I've got for the day right there. So that's added the shopping in there. Now, I have absolutely no idea why reminders moved that task. I don't know how it's organizing this. I don't know what it's supposed to be doing, but it doesn't really matter. It's actually there. I've got my task. I know what I'm going to do and everything is good to go. So there you go. That's how I would do the daily and weekly planning using my reminders. Hopefully this has given you some ideas. Thank you very much for watching this video, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, if you want to take your Apple productivity systems to the next level and you want to bring in your calendar, your reminders, your iCloud and your Apple Notes all together into one beautiful productivity system, then please take a look at my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course. It's completely updated for Mac OS Big Sur and iOS 14, and it's readily available now. All you need to do is pop over to my learning center, get yourself enrolled, and within about 90 minutes to 2 hours, you're gonna have yourself the know-how to build your very own Apple productivity system. I hope you join me in this course. This course now includes how to set up the Apple system using the time sector system, so you get a modern day time management system fit for the world that we live in today and the world that we're probably about to move into next year in 2021-2022. Okay, thanks very much for watching this video, and I really do hope you join me in this course.